Hi everyone, this is Architect Neil Koletkar from Architects Academy, and today I am going to tell you about the NATA exam. So many of the students who are watching this video must be in the 8th, 9th, 10th or 11th standard, or maybe they will be doing the HSC exam this year. So basically we will start with the full form of NATA exam. So it is the National Aptitude Test in Architecture. It is a mandatory entrance exam to get admission to BArch, that is architecture course. So all of the students who want to become an architect or to take admission to architecture course must give this exam in the month of April. Now this exam is conducted by the Council of Architecture in New Delhi. The exam is conducted in the month of April every year. So you have to start thinking about this exam at least 6 months in advance. This exam is conducted in two parts. Part A will be the aesthetic sensitivity test and part B will be the drawing test. Now in the aesthetic sensitivity test, it is going to be an online test for 120 marks, in which there will be 60 multiple choice questions which will be asked to you. And the advantage of this is that there is no negative marking in this test. So the student has to attempt all the 60 questions which appear in front of his screen. The part B, which is the drawing test. Now this is going to be a pencil and paper based test which is conducted out of 80 marks. Now in this test there are going to be two drawing questions which will be asked to the candidate, and they will be for 40 marks each. Now the total time which is going to be given for you for drawing is 1.5 hour. So you need to finish two drawings in 1.5 hour span. Generally the drawings which will be asked to you will be either from memory sketch or a 2D composition or a 3-dimensional composition. The total duration of the exam is going to be of 3 hours. So the first 1.5 hour will be given for the multiple choice questions and the later half will be given for the drawing section. So the total marks for this NATA exam are going to be out of 200. Now to qualify for the admission to architecture, the candidates needs to score minimum of 30 marks out of 120 in part A, that is the multiple choice questions, and 20 marks out of 80 in part B, that is the drawing section. Now this basic question is there for everyone, that is where to apply for this exam. Now let me tell you that the application forms for NATA exam are made available in month of December or January every year on the following website, which reads as www.nata.in. So what I will suggest students is that you keep following this website right from the month of October, so that you will stay updated so as to when the admission forms will be uploaded. Now to be eligible for attempting NATA exam, the following qualification criteria must be fulfilled. So if you want to take admission to architecture, now according to the change rules, you must have PCM group, that is the physics, chemistry and maths subjects have been made mandatory. So those students who are in 10th standard, they need to choose their subjects wisely in the 11th standard if they want to do architecture as the career. So the basic criteria will be 10 plus 2 with physics, chemistry, maths as subject and minimum 50% aggregate percentage. Now where we come in. So basically Architects Academy will offer free career guidance for students who wish to pursue architecture as the career. So to book your appointment for the free career guidance session, you can call on the number given below, that is 98200-85841, or send us an email on architectsacademy@gmail.com and we will be most happy to help you. Now we also conduct 1 year, 2 year course for NATA exam preparation, and we also have a special crash course which is available for the students of 12th standard. We also provide the study material and test series for NATA exam. So I hope I have given you the basic information about NATA exam. For further information, you can contact me on the numbers which I have already given to you, or send me an email on architectsacademy@gmail.com. So I hope this video has helped you to understand about the NATA exam.